Holst was absolutely desperate to be involved in the First World War, and unfortunately his health wasn't good enough for him to be able to do so. But he was able to go out to Salonika with the YMCA to teach music to the troops, and he also organised concerts to entertain them as well.
So the event today is all about Holst in Salonika and the food that the troops may have eaten in Salonika. Some of the food that Holst himself would have eaten with the YMCA and also within Salonika itself, but also some of the food that the troops, reflecting their diversity, some of the troops were Indian, North African, obviously there were French troops, the Serbians. So some of that food is reflecting the types of food that they would have known from home.
Away from the Western Front is a deliberate attempt to try and focus the commemorations of the First World War centenary away from the Western Front.
There are two ways to really get people interested in this. One is to focus on actual people who were there rather than talking about where regiments went and what happened in such and such a date. So focusing on the actual experience of a person so that they've got letters to them, photos and so on, it becomes alive. Once you've got that material, the research material, is to use it to make a meaning for yourself so that you have a work of art coming out of it, or a piece of music or some drama or an animation or something like that, so that you've had a chance to actually identify with this person and find out what it means to you. So that's really what this whole project has been about, is to get people to think about the life of Holst in Salonika, but in a way that is personal to them, through music, through food, through talking about his life and things that he did.
In June 1919, when he returned back, in that following summer, the first piece, significant piece, that he composed was Ode to Death. And Imogen Holst, his daughter, is on record saying that it was dedicated to his friend Cecil Coles, who was a First World War composer and perhaps one of the biggest losses in terms of composers who died during the First World War. And his experiences of being in Salonika, his experiences on the home front, would have poured into this work and inspired it and, you know, made him make that dedication.